This is where they are building the largest nuclear fusion reactor in the world.
Build and deploy low-cost electricity for the whole world.
Is that we could create a mini sun, the right kind of mini sun, hold it there for a sustained period.
Nuclear fusion holds incredible promise, going far beyond what you can imagine. It has the potential to power stars, offering practically unlimited energy without any carbon emissions. Germany's scientists just confirmed they've made a massive breakthrough in their newest nuclear fusion reactor that shocks the entire industry. If we can recreate it on Earth, it could revolutionize our energy landscape. Unlike current nuclear tech, fusion doesn't leave us with long-term radioactive waste. For years, achieving fusion seemed just out of reach, but the potential rewards are so huge that billions of dollars are pouring into the field. Germany's leading plasma research facility recently set a new record with its fusion reactor, bringing us a step closer to the fantastic goal of fusion power, an almost limitless source of clean and renewable energy. But how exactly does this reactor work, and how does it compare to the pioneering ITER reactor? Join us as we dive into this new fusion reactor and why it shocked the entire space industry. How the nuclear fusion reactor works. Scientists at Germany's Max Planck Institute for Plasma Physics recently achieved a significant milestone in their quest to develop a nuclear fusion reactor, often referred to as a holy grail for physicists. Unlike traditional nuclear fission reactors that produce hazardous radioactive waste, fusion involves connecting atoms rather than separating them. The experimental reactor, known as the Wendelstein 7X Stellarator, made its debut in late 2015. This innovative device, resembling a donut-shaped core, is designed to hold plasma formed by colliding hydrogen atoms. By subjecting the plasma to intense microwave blasts, scientists were able to elevate its temperature to a staggering 100 million degrees. At this extreme heat, the nuclei of the atoms fuse, creating helium and generating energy in a process that mirrors the sun's core. In a breakthrough moment, the Wendelstein 7X demonstrated its ability to maintain a loop of helium ions at a million degrees for a brief but significant tenth of a second. Subsequent experiments, with 18 times more energy supplied, witnessed the plasma's temperature soaring to a blistering 40 million degrees Kelvin, four times hotter than before. Put this into perspective. The sun's surface temperature is a mere 5,505 degrees Celsius. This showcases the immense power of the Stellarator. While traditional nuclear energy relies on the disintegration of large atoms, fusion energy emerges from the fusion of atoms, presenting a promising and cleaner alternative for the future. Unlike atom-splitting power, fusion doesn't produce the same radiation issues, except for the presence of radioactive panels lining the reactor's interior walls. The Wendelstein 7X Stellarator represents a leap toward harnessing safe, clean nuclear energy with the potential to revolutionize our energy landscape. Fusion stands out as an exceptionally clean way to generate electricity. Imagine needing to deliver a powerful kick, equivalent to about 100 million degrees, to get things started. This requires a special machine, and there are two promising types. The W7X is one of these, using electromagnetic fields from plasma to keep charged particles in check. Unlike traditional methods like MIT's Alcator C-Mod tokamak, which resembles a writhing jelly donut, the W7X, a Stellarator, maintains control with magnetic coils. Despite not matching the output of tokamaks, the W7X's 15-meter-wide machine seems to be a potential bridge, offering more extended periods of energy generation. Additionally, the ETA nuclear reactor emerges as another technology paving the way for a new era in nuclear fusion. While the idea of nuclear reactors might sound strange, it's been around for a while. Back in the 1940s, nuclear fusion played a risky part in making the world's first really dangerous hydrogen bomb, finished in 1952. Even though it had a big explosive start, fusion energy hasn't fully reached its potential for sustainable development. Now, things are changing with Germany's groundbreaking nuclear fusion reactor. It's pushing us towards a future where we can live better and more sustainably. This invention has the potential to change how we get energy, opening the door to a greener and safer tomorrow. Now let's dive into why this is important. Construction and significance of nuclear fusion reactor. Germany's Max Planck Institute for Plasma Physics, IPP, has built a special nuclear fusion reactor. It's like a 5 meter tall and 15 meter wide wonder. Picture this reactor creating energy just like the sun does. It's a huge achievement, not just because of its size. This big invention could unlock powerful nuclear energy, changing the world of science and tech. Think about a future where this tech becomes a major energy source, satisfying Earth's hunger for power. It's a game changer that might disconnect us from relying on the sun for energy. This new fusion reactor is stunning because it gives us clean energy. And it's not just about Earth. It could lead to big things in space. The massive energy it produces could help build giant spaceships, powering them without needing stars far away. Imagine a society traveling between stars, using energy from this fusion reactor. It's not just a dream. It could open up new possibilities for space exploration. This is a big jump that doesn't just help us now, but sets us up for an amazing future. The best part? This new nuclear reactor is unlike anything we've ever seen. The Wendelstein 7X Stellarator. Building something as impressive as the Wendelstein 7X took a really long time, a whopping 19 years. Smart people worked hard on its unique design. Even though it doesn't make electricity on its own, this powerful thing helps us learn about important stuff for future fusion power plants. It's like a super cool upgrade from its older version, the Wendelstein 7AS. After two successful phases, it took a little break for upgrades and came back in 2022. Slowly but surely, it cranked up its power to try and keep a special plasma thing going for 30 whole minutes. This is a big deal because it shows how a future fusion power plant can keep running non-stop. Meanwhile, in Germany, scientists at the Max Planck Institute did something intriguing. They turned on this groundbreaking device, creating super hot hydrogen plasma. Imagine a donut-shaped gadget zapping hydrogen atoms with microwaves, making them incredibly hot at 100 million degrees. Can you think of any other place that generates this much energy? This whole process mimics what goes on at the sun's core, but surprisingly, it's 7 times hotter. Now you understand the incredible power at play here. In 2015, the Wendelstein 7X, like a tiny star, showed it can keep helium ions super hot for a bit. Later, they cranked up the heat to a crazy 40 million degrees Kelvin, much hotter than the sun. The sun's surface is a chilly 5,505 degrees Celsius in comparison. Imagine how super powerful the Wendelstein 7X is. It's mind-blowing. You know about regular nuclear energy, right? It happens when big atoms break apart. Fusion energy, on the other hand, is different. It comes from atoms teaming up. This cool energy source has big potential for the future. Unlike the radiation issues linked to splitting atoms, fusion is a super clean way to make electricity. Just ignore the radioactive panels on the reactor's walls. Fusion is the cleanest way to generate power. Achieving fusion requires a colossal effort, a forceful kick equivalent to a scorching 100 million degrees. Now you'd be pondering the mind-bending heat involved in fusion. One might wonder how any material could endure such extremes. The challenge intensifies when pondering how scientists manage to corral this ferocious energy. Fear not, for the brilliant minds at Germany's Max Planck Institute for Plasma Physics have cracked the code. Their innovative solutions not only withstand the searing temperatures, but also confine the unleashed energy. These revelations are the keys to unlocking controlled fusion within the confines of a laboratory setting. This historic task requires a specialized machine, and two promising types have emerged. One of them is the Wendelstein 7X, boasting electromagnetic fields produced by the resulting plasma. This is similar to the mechanisms employed by MIT's Alcator CMOD tokamak, ensuring the stability of the charged particle-filled jelly donut against a backdrop of a hot slam-dancing cloud. Fuel injection and stellarators. Fuel injection, despite yielding incredible energy, struggles with instabilities that make sustained power generation elusive. Similarly, stellarators like the Wendelstein 7X deploy banks of magnetic coils to masterfully contain the plasma. This approach provides more control, allowing the hot ring of helium jelly to swirl for prolonged periods. While not quite matching the output of the tokamak, Wendelstein 7X's impressive 15-meter-wide apparatus appears poised to bridge that gap, presenting a potential breakthrough in the pursuit of cleaner, more sustainable energy. ITER Nuclear Reactor. The ITER Nuclear Reactor is set to revolutionize the world of nuclear fusion power. It's a groundbreaking technology, currently under construction at Cadarache, a French research center that delves into nuclear power. Imagine a colossal machine, the world's first and largest of its kind, taking shape to produce a whopping 500 megawatts of power. This is achieved through the fusion of two hydrogen types, deuterium and tritium, generating 10 times the energy needed to operate the ITER. As it nears completion in late 2025, the ITER will stand tall with a diameter and height of 100 feet each, truly a marvel in nuclear fusion devices. Imagine it as not only the largest magnetic confinement plasma physics experiment, but also the grandest experimental tokamak nuclear fusion reactor globally. Despite tokamak's incompleteness, you'd need to know how they work. How tokamak and Wendelstein 7X works. Considering a parallel marvel in the form of a stellarator, the Wendelstein 7X, boasting 50 superconducting magnet coils, stands at approximately 3.5 meters tall. Unlike the traditional donut shape of a tokamak, the stellarator locks plasma in a captivating, twisting, and spiraling configuration. Here, the electrons and ions are orchestrated to flow around the tube in an electric current, induced by a transformer-like setup. This current creates a vertical, looping magnetic field, merging seamlessly with the existing field along the tube's length, giving rise to the essential spiraling field lines. It's a fascinating dance of forces and elements, all in pursuit of unlocking the potential of nuclear fusion. Yet the tokamak outshines its counterparts in plasma retention. The symmetrical design of a tokamak facilitates smoother particle pathways, a feature that sets it apart. In addition to its peculiar design, the Wendelstein 7X boasts an intricate structure with a multitude of twists and turns. This oddity stems from the magnetic field employed to confine plasma within the device. Known as a stellarator, this contraption utilizes a sophisticated three-dimensional arrangement of coils and loops to navigate the turbulent journey of hot plasma, maintaining stability throughout the loops. Imagine it as a colossal, optimized donut, a feat of engineering complexity. What's intriguing is that this shape draws inspiration from the inaugural stellarator crafted by astrophysicist Lyman Spitzer in 1951. Spitzer's original invention, resembling a figure eight, paved the way for the Princeton Plasma Physics Laboratory, PPPL, in New Jersey. Over time, the lab shifted to a simpler method, charting the evolution of stellar exploration. In contrast, stellarators often lose microscopic particles, posing a challenge that has fueled fusion studies since the 1970s and spurred monumental projects like the ITER reactor. Now, envision the Wendelstein 7X, the stellarator, enhanced with graphite tiles on its internal wall. This innovation elevates temperatures within, pushing the boundaries of what's achievable. The internal lining, aptly named a diverter, not only shields the twisting chamber walls, but empowers operators. It allows for the injection of plasma at higher temperatures, offering precise control over hydrogen plasma density and purity. The optimization of the Wendelstein 7X is a testament to the feasibility of stellarator-type fusion reactors for power facilities. To overcome past accelerator limitations, extensive theoretical and computational efforts were invested in crafting a magnetic field. This field serves the dual purpose of containing the heated plasma and preventing it from reaching the vessel's sides. A paramount goal was minimizing energy losses caused by the magnetic field's ripple effect. Even though plasma particles are tethered to the magnetic field lines, efforts were made to curtail outward drift and prevent losses, marking a significant stride in fusion reactor design. In contrast, tokamaks boast minimal losses thanks to their symmetrical structure that mitigates magnetic field ripple effects. Stellarators, on the other hand, contend with challenges like small vortex motions and turbulence, both contributing to energy losses. To bridge this gap and match tokamak's confinement efficiency, the Wendelstein 7X undertook a magnetic field overhaul, strategically designed to minimize these losses. The results are impressive. Wendelstein 7X has not only achieved high-temperature plasmas, but also clinched the Stellarator world record for fusion products at elevated temperatures, using the best available heating equipment. This triumphant combination of plasma temperature, density, and energy confinement duration brings us remarkably close to the coveted values for burning plasma. Delving deeper into this accomplishment, detailed analysis reveals that even though turbulent losses were negligible at these heightened plasma temperatures, neoclassical losses claimed a substantial 30% of the heating power. This underscores their importance in the energy balance of the system. A fascinating thought experiment explored the impact of Wendelstein 7X's neoclassical optimization. When applying the same plasma values and profiles achieved in the record-setting scenario to less optimized magnetic fields, a stark revelation emerged. The projected neoclassical losses exceeded the input heating power, rendering it physically impossible. This realization emphasized that the unique plasma profiles witnessed in Wendelstein 7X are only feasible under magnetic fields with low neoclassical losses. It's a testament to the delicate balance and precision required in magnetic field adjustments, showcasing how the Wendelstein magnetic field manipulation successfully curtailed neoclassical losses. However, tokamaks face significant drawbacks. The use of a transformer results in brief pulses of current across the plasma, an inadequacy for a commercial fusion reactor. Sudden faltering of the plasma current can lead to disruptions and rapid losses of plasma confinement that unleash powerful magnetic forces, risking damage to the reactor. Even newer designs, like the spherical tokamak, grapple with these issues. In contrast, Stellarators shine in stability. With no circulating plasma current, disruptions are sidestepped. External coils generate fields without the need for pulsing. This stability not only ensures safety, but also contributes to cleaner power generation. Unlike reactors that produce heat by splitting atoms in controlled nuclear reactions, the Wendelstein 7X, while not producing energy on its own, lays the groundwork for a Stellarator reactor capable of running indefinitely. This tantalizing prospect inches us closer to a world of nearly boundless energy, harnessed from the same process that powers the sun. It's a visionary step toward a future fueled by sustainable and limitless energy. Germany plans to spend more than 1 billion euro on nuclear fusion research by 2028. As reported by Soren Amelang to Clean Energy Wire, the German government is gearing up for a quantum leap in energy research, committing over 1 billion euros in the next 5 years to propel fusion into the limelight. According to Research Minister Bettina Stark-Watzinger of the Free Democrats, fusion stands as a monumental opportunity to untangle our energy woes. She confidently asserted that the question isn't whether fusion will become a reality, but rather whether Germany will be a trailblazer in this groundbreaking field. Stark-Watzinger recently unveiled a robust support program, injecting 370 million euros into ongoing initiatives at the Institute for Plasma Physics, the Karlsruhe Institute of Technology, and the research center Jülich, forging a fusion-focused alliance with industry. This strategic investment aims to cultivate a collaborative fusion ecosystem that paves the way for a German fusion power plant at the earliest. Germany, as per the research ministry's recent paper, already commands a leading position in fusion research, and these investments are poised to leverage that advantage, setting the stage for a new era in sustainable energy.